Hi everyone, it's Helen Hotai here, founder of Form Help, and we will go straight into part two of the Australia DPD, the app version, and we will be looking at the health information section, which has been unlocked. So go ahead and log into your account and we'll get started. Now, exactly 72 hours from your departure flight, you should receive an email like this, notifying you that you are now able to submit to your health declaration. And note it says, please do so before your flight. Okay, let's get straight into it. Now, continuing on from yesterday, so we did submit the trip details, we submitted the quarantine details. Now we're going to go into the health information section. So see how it's got commenced? So that means we can begin. So go ahead and select health information. Next, you'll see that it reads, before you travel to or transit through Australia, you must present proof of a negative COVID-19, polymerase chain reaction or PCR, or nucleic acid amplification test, the NAAT, taken within 3 days of your flight's scheduled departure to Australia, or a medical certificate as evidence of a negative rapid antigen test, RAT, taken under medical supervision within 24 hours before your flight's scheduled departure to Australia. Now, to find out if you are exempt or for more information, click on the link below. Now, in regards to the PCR or the NAAT, you must take it within 3 days or 72 hours of your flight, your departure flight to Australia. Now, I have had many queries from people asking whether they need to submit their PCR NAAT test results exactly 72 hours before their departure flight. You have 72 hours, a window frame of 72 hours wherein you need to get your PCR or your NAAT test done, get your result, and then upload it. So you have 72 hours to get all that done. So it doesn't have to be exactly 72 hours on the dot and then you need to submit it. No, you have 72 hours wherein to get all that done. However, with the RAT, you only have a 24-hour window wherein to get your test done, get your test result, and then upload your result to the health information section. Okay, let's look at the first question on this page. Now, in the 3 days before the day of your flight to Australia was scheduled to commence, have you been exposed without adequate personal protective precautions to a person who tested positive for COVID-19? Now, select yes or no. And if you did select yes, the following question is, have you tested positive to COVID-19 in the 7 days before your planned departure for Australia, or are you currently experiencing any symptoms of COVID-19, such as fever, sore throat, or a cough? Yes or no. Next question, are you an Australian citizen, permanent resident, or immediate family member? Yes or no. Has a doctor ever told you that you had COVID-19, or have you ever tested positive for COVID-19? Yes or no? Now, if you did respond yes, then you need to provide the month and year of the diagnosis and what country were you in when you had COVID-19. And note below, giving false or misleading information to the Australian government is a serious offence. Penalties apply to breaches of state and territory public health orders. Next, you will need to select one of the following. So the two options are, number one, I am exempt from Australia's COVID-19 testing requirements. And the second option is, I was tested for COVID-19 prior to my departure to Australia in accordance with Australian government requirements and received a negative test result. So go ahead, make your selection. And next it says, I declare I am fully vaccinated with an Australian approved or recognised COVID-19 vaccine. I have evidence to support this. My last dose of the vaccine was at least 7 days before the day of my flight is scheduled to commence. So go ahead and select yes or no. And if you did select no, underneath it says, I am under 18 years of age and not fully vaccinated. So go ahead and make your selection. There's yes or no. Now for parents who are filling in the DPDs for their young children, for example, if I had a 3-year-old who hasn't been vaccinated, then I would select I am under 18 years of age and not fully vaccinated. Yes, that is correct. I would select a yes in this case. However, if you do select to know that you are not under 18, the next bit says I am over 18 years of age and declare I cannot be vaccinated for medical reasons. I have medical proof to support this. See the proof of medical exemption when coming to Australia link. So click on that for more information. And if you do select a yes, it will come up with, if you are claiming a medical exemption from COVID-19 vaccination, please attach evidence here. So you see there is a box with the option that says to add image or photo. So this is where you get to upload your evidence of your medical exemption. And remembering that the accepted files are JPG, JPEG, PNG, and the max file size is 5 megabytes. So please ensure that you do not exceed that and that it is in the accepted format. Now, in regards to uploading your evidence, so when clicking on the add image or photo option, it will ask you whether you want to upload an image or you can take a photo of your evidence and upload it straight from there. So that will be nice and quick. Otherwise, you can just upload it from a file on your phone. Now, for this section, if you answered no to most of those questions, then you'll likely go through this section a lot quicker than someone who has answered yes to those questions. Either way, once you've answered all of those questions, proceed to continue. Okay, next we come to the vaccination details. So it says, please ensure all doses are added, including booster, before leaving this page. So go ahead and click on the blue box that says add. Next, you'll see this come up. So it says add a COVID-19 vaccination certificate. So you can see there's two options. So the top one is scan QR code of an Australian issued international COVID-19 vaccination certificate. And the bottom option is manually enter details. So if you do have an Australian issued vaccination certificate, then go ahead and choose that top option. Whereas if you don't, go ahead and manually enter your details. So if you do choose the Australian one, we'll have a look at what it entails. So as you can see here, it says scan vaccination certificate QR code. So you need to place your certificate on a flat surface and then take a picture. Okay, now if we are manually entering our details, then it will come up with the screen here. So vaccination certificate, please fill out your vaccination certificate details. Now the details on here, the name of the holder, the passport number, the date of birth, the gender, it's already been pre-filled, probably due to the scanning of the passport earlier on. But if we scroll down below, you will need to input some information here. So go ahead and put in your date of vaccination. Now, I have had queries as to which date people should put on there, especially if they've had three different dates, for example, their first shot, their second shot, and then their third shot being the booster shot. Personally, I would just go ahead and put in the latest date. So that would be my booster shot date. However, that is not gospel, so if you wanted to double check with the Global Service Centre, then give them a call. And remembering that you'll also have an uploaded copy of your vaccination records as well. So if they needed to refer to your records, they'll have access to it. Now go ahead and put in your dose number. For example, if you've had two shots and one booster, then that would be three doses. And then go ahead and put in the country of vaccination and then put in the center that administered the vaccination and also put in the batch number. And you'll notice there that there isn't an asterisk for those two questions. So that means that it's optional. So if you don't remember the center or you don't know the batch number, then that's okay. You can leave that blank. Next, you will need to enter your vaccination brand. So this will come up. So scroll through and select your option and then proceed to confirm. Now, if you have had two different vaccination brands, it looks like, but I could be wrong, that you can only enter one. So if you're in this situation, put in at least one of your vaccination brands, and remembering that you will be uploading your vaccination details, which will have a full record of all your vaccination history. So if they needed to, they can refer to the copy they have of your DPD application if they needed to. Next, to put in the disease or agent targeted. Again, it doesn't have an asterisk, but if you wanted to put in there COVID-19, go ahead and put that in. Underneath, you can see that the certificate accepted files are again JPG, JPEG, PNG, and the max file size is 5 megabytes. Now let's go ahead and upload our certificates. So the box there that says add image or photo, go ahead and click on that. And then next you will see this box here, it says upload photo. So you have two options, you can either take a photo or choose an image. So we'll go ahead and select the take a photo option. So at this stage you should have your vaccination certificates or documents, evidence ready for you to take a photo of those. And once it's in place, then take your photo. And as you can see in the bottom corners of the screen, you have a retake option or use the photo. So if you're happy with the photo of your certificate or your evidence, then just press use photo. If you need to retake the photo, then select retake the photo until you're happy with it. And for choose image, select one of the images and then press choose image. Next you'll see your image or your photo, it would be shown as above, and then proceed to confirm. Okay, so you'll notice we're back at the vaccination details. Again, it reminds us to include our booster shot record. Now also below in the white box, this is where our records that we have uploaded will show up in this white box here. Now if you do need to add another record because your first and second shots and your booster shots are all on separate documents, then go ahead to the add another option in the blue box and follow that same process that we just went over. Now once you're all done and you're back at this page, check in the white box that all the documents you've loaded are showing up or listed in there, and then proceed to continue. Okay, next you will see the COVID-19 test results. So it says each COVID-19 test you have received is detailed below, so we want to add our results. So let's go ahead and press on the blue box to the left that says add results. So as you can see here, it says COVID-19 test results. Please fill in your COVID-19 test results data. And the first question is type of COVID test that you've had. If you select the drop-down arrow, it will show the options that you have to choose from. And as you can see, there are only two options for you to choose from. So there's the COVID-19 PCR NAAT or the RAT. So make your selection and proceed to confirm. And the next question is the outcome of your COVID-19 test. And you have three options there. Were you positive, negative, or inconclusive? So make your selection. And then go ahead and put in the date the COVID-19 test was conducted. And then the country where the COVID-19 test was conducted. And the place where the COVID-19 test was conducted. And then upload your certificate. And again, just follow that same process that we went through when uploading your vaccination certificate or evidence. And once you've done all of that, then you can proceed to confirm. And on the next page, you'll be able to review your health information. So in this example, you can see that the health declaration is complete, the COVID-19 vaccinations is complete, and the COVID-19 test is incomplete because there is no COVID, NAAT or RAT test been done or uploaded yet. So if you're in that situation, go to the save and exit box until your results arrive or until you've had your test and your results arrive. But once you are finished all of that and you are happy to submit the health information section, then go ahead and submit. And that's you pretty much done. Now, once you have completed and submitted all three sections. So that's number one, the trip details, number two, the quarantine details, and number three, the health information, you need to await your reply from the Department of Home Affairs. Now, I know some people receive their approval straight away, whereas others don't, but use the guide that you should receive a reply before you board your flight. And if it is 24 hours before your flight and you still haven't heard or received an email from them, then reach out to the Global Service Centre and seek advice from them. And I will place their contact details in the description box below. Also, don't forget to check your spam mail as well, in case your reply landed in there. Now, on the day of travel, this is your checklist. Ensure that you have a copy of your DPD summary, your negative COVID-19 test result, and your vaccination evidence or your exemption, okay? Some people probably prefer to take a digital copy of all these things, but I'm really old school. I would prefer to have a hard copy as well. So even if you do have a digital copy, I would just have a hard copy just in case. You just never know, in case you lose your phone or, you know, it runs out of battery or whatever, at least you'll have a hard copy on you. And when you do hear from the Department of Home Affairs through the email, you should expect one of these replies. So complete. So if you receive a complete reply, the information you have entered in your declaration indicates you meet COVID-19 health requirements for boarding, and you will still need to show your documentation at check-in, and your airline will make the final decision to let you board your flight. Now, if you receive an incomplete email, it will be because you have not submitted your health information, the digital passenger declaration requests, critical health information, and you must be able to show evidence that you completed the critical information before boarding. And the third reply you could expect is confirmation required at check-in. So this means you may not have met the requirements for travel to Australia and you need to be confirmed at check-in. Your airline will decide if you can travel, and if the airline allows you to travel to Australia, you may need to quarantine on arrival. Before you start your DPD, you should check the Department of Health website, and this has details on the important health rules passengers need to follow when coming to Australia. So expect one of those three replies from the Department of Home Affairs. So complete or incomplete or confirmation required at check-in. And if you do receive a confirmation required at check-in, I do know of one person who has received that reply and they were still able to get on their flight freely. There was no dramas at all. Now, because the DPD on this tutorial was for training purposes only, it will not be submitted. And that concludes the tutorial for the health information section of the Australia DPD. Hopefully it was able to help you in some way. If you know of anyone who needs help with the DPD, feel free to share this tutorial with them. And if we're able to impart some little help to someone, it will make a positive difference. So all the best with your DPD applications. And if it gets too stressful, just go and take a little break and then come back to it. And that's me, Helen Hotai, founder of Form Help, signing out. Thanks for listening. Don't forget to like and subscribe.